Hi guys, Assalamualikum, hello, hi, and once again, welcome to my kitchen, cooking is fun with your dolls. And today's recipe is chicken baked biryani. And it's going to be fun doing this. Baking of biryani idea has emerged from US. Last year I went to US and then I have my sister-in-law. Since we were there, she invited all her friends for a meal on Eid, and we had to cook mutton biryani, and we didn't have that big pressure cooker to tenderize the meat. So she was the one who gave me this idea of baking in the marinated mutton pieces in the oven. And the meat pieces came out so beautifully tender, very juicy. So in case you are making some huge amount of biryani and you don't have that much big pressure cooker to cook your mutton pieces, what you can do is you can just use your oven to tenderize your mutton pieces. This is it. This is the story behind this. So let's start making in the chicken biryani to be baked. So it's like the chicken baked biryani. Let's start it. As you can see, the chicken is already marinated here, but don't worry, I recorded how I did the marination. So just have a look at the marination first and then we'll come back and start with the next.
So let's begin with the marination now. We'll add ginger garlic paste, curd, that's salt, tandoori masala, 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder, less than a teaspoon of coriander. This biryani masala recipe is already there in the videos, so you can have a look. So biryani masala, I'm going to add around 3 to 4 tablespoons of biryani masala. Now since my biryani masala already has enough of garam masala, I will not add too much. So here we go with only 2 cloves, 2 star anise parts, 1 nutmeg, just 2-3 mace flakes, small pieces of cinnamon, 2 cardamom cloves. Now let's pour in the oil. Now we are not going to add ghee at this point of time, we'll save this, later we are going to add this. So let's mix all the masalas together. Okay, so now let this marinate.
So once this marination is done, we'll add this ghee to the chicken. I have a baking tray with me wherein I can easily put around 1.5 kg of chicken and then layer the rice on top of it. So I'm just going to brush it with some ghee which is left in my hand. Apply the ghee to the chicken pieces.
Now we will place the chicken pieces onto this baking tray.
There you go. Use gloves, guys. Very important. Safety first. Okay. So this is done. Now let me show you how you have to bake this. The oven is getting preheated at 250 degrees Celsius. Here you go. Now this is gonna cook, bake in the oven for 35 to 40 minutes.
While the chicken is getting baked, we will get the other things ready, like fried onions. Here I have used 2 large onions sliced and fried, 1/2 cup of mint, 1 cup of chopped coriander, 3 to 4 green chilies, you can increase the numbers you want, 1/2 lemon, and 1 large tomato chopped finely. So just have a look at the chicken, how beautifully it's getting baked.
Now the chicken is coming off the oven. We have our vegetables, onion, fried, and everything is ready here. So now we'll start with the layering.
So let's begin layering. First I'll drizzle some mint leaves along with some coriander leaves and chopped tomatoes, fried onions,
some green chilies and squeeze the lemon. So after squeezing in the lemon, I'm going to layer my rice. This is 60% cooked rice. So once I layer this, give a nice tap. Nice thick layer, okay? And then drizzle again coriander leaves, mint leaves, fried onions, chopped tomatoes and few green chilies. There you go. So once this is done, we will layer another layer of rice now. But this is going to be a thin layer, not a thick layer. As I told you, it is 60% cooked rice. So once I layer this, I'm going to drizzle some saffron water, which I have soaked already with some saffron strands and some red food color, because it adds a good texture to your biryani. Once this is done, I'm going to wrap it using an aluminium foil. And this is going to bake in the preheated oven at 250 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. Minimum 40, so maximum 60. So once this is done, let me open it up. I can smell beautiful aroma all over my kitchen. And this looks so yum, guys. Very less oil, very less ghee, yet we get to enjoy your healthy recipe. So you should definitely give it a try, and you should share your experience in the comments below. Let me know how was it. Look at the layer of rice grain. It's like just like restaurant style, but better than the restaurant ones. Steaming hot biryani is ready, and I'm going to take my bite. Let me show you. The chicken is so beautifully cooked and tendered. Normally chickens are never cooked tendered, they get little tougher, and if they get tougher they don't taste good. But this one, I'm sure I'm going to taste and tell you. Oh, this is so good.
Okay guys, here you go. The biryani is ready now. The baked biryani is ready. So do try this recipe and share your comments below. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. There's still lots more to come with Cooking is Fun with Firdaus.